Bonjour, bonsoir, dear friends. JCB Live, Wine Style. Today's a special day. It's a root day. A day well anchored in the ground, like Joe Papendick. Dear friends, join me to wish Joe happy birthday.
Cheers.
How does it feel to be born on March 9?
Wonderful. Very happy to be here. It's a glorious day.
And it's in the horoscope. It is
Pisces.
And yeah. What does it mean to you, Pisces?
Ooh, what does it mean? It definitely means...
As a man of earth, you are a sign of water.
Sign of water, yes. Sign of creativity, sign of fluidity, movement, change. For me, it's often definitely that the creativity side comes out in being Pisces, of being something that looking at different angles and moving with the flow like water.
I would agree with that. Yes. You need to be next to the water. Hence California. How far is the ocean from where we are?
We're about 45 minutes away from the ocean, so the furthest I've been in a long time. So I do get a little bit, I miss it, but it's good. It's close enough that we can, if we need to on a warm day or even in a cool day, head over there very quickly.
But look at the magnificent vineyards we around. I mean, dear friends, look at where we are in the heart of wine country. We're tasting a North Coast, very symbolic of what California is all about. It's a Buena Vista Vinicultural Society. And as you can see, this is the first winery in California. The winery which actually brought this very fabulous pruning techniques to California. Look, we've pruned our vineyards. We are March 9th, so roughly 5 weeks ago. And many of you were on the Wine Style to see how we prune. It was a great session. And you could see the wood is drier and now it's growing. So slowly but surely, we're gonna document for you the evolution of the vineyards. But we are living kind of a dream time. This has been fairly wet. Hence you could see the grass is beautifully green and we have the mustard, you know, carpeting the vineyards, and this is very cool. There's no more beautiful colors in the wine country than this, Joe. So why mustard and why building competition in the soil?
In the soil. This is a very important time of the year. I say this is when it all begins, is in the soil, as we always say. We focus on the vine, we love the grapes, but all the hard work is happening with the plants that are around it. We can see below us and around us the mustard. The mustard's a little bit of an accident. It's something that has taken off, it spreads, it seeds prolifically, and it ends up taking, we had a dry winter in the beginning of winter, and the seeds were able to get established and blooming.
Rain came at a perfect time.
Perfect time for them to germinate. The mustard does help us. It provides a nice deep root to provide biomass and organic matter in the soil, which helps to retain moisture. Which is going to be very important for a dry year. We'll be able to, when we mow or have our friends here, the sheep, chewing this down, it's allowing the energy from and the biomass to return back to the soil and feeding that soil. In addition to mustard, there's a number of other different plants that are in here. We have a cover crop mix, fava beans, peas, vetch, and oats. The top first three, the bell bean, fava bean, peas, vetch, all are able to take nitrogen out of our atmosphere and fixate it into the soil. Nitrogen is essential for leaf growth and for development of plants. So it's able to add a naturally occurring process of fertilization. The grasses that we have here add that competition, and that competition of roots that are coming through, stimulating, pushing on other roots, because when you're needing to compete, when you're being pushed and probed, you end up producing more. And so by being encouraged with the root mass of oats or with grasses, with mustard, you end up pushing out more growth and being stimulated to grow. And those roots also provide networks for fungal development, and then they can stimulate and feed the plant naturally. When we add synthetic fertilizers, the roots stop doing that aspect. So it's very important to have an organic soil, organic management of the entire property, so that those roots can naturally add those fungal networks, and that also helps to fight off pests. And it all comes from this rainforest jungle of life, the web of life, the soil web that's happening in our soil below our feet, and it's invisible essentially.
So well said. This is the market economy, the market ecosystem, dear friends. This is what we need to create this amazing soil. And this is why this North Coast is so incredible. Maybe, Joe, you describe it to us, because I know you love North Coast Chardonnay. This really speaks volume to you. And frankly, when you smell that mustard, dear friends, I know it's hard to transcribe the smell, but you understand why the bees are coming. You understand why all the insects, so appetizing. You want to bite into it. And this is the famous mustard that originally in Burgundy, in history, we're talking from the 11th century till the 19th, was really making the mustard seeds to actually make the famous Dijon mustards. So this is where we are, and all that mustard grew naturally here in California.
Yes. So it was imported. It did come from Europe.
Well, of course, originally.
Yes. So when we brought over alfalfa for animals, when we brought over different crops, mustard seed, because it seeds so prolifically, it gets into other things and is passed along.
You can see that beautiful seeds right here as an example. And those are the seeds we use in mustard making. And we basically put it on a stone press, and you extract a little bit of oil, and this is what mustard is all about. And this is what we call stone press mustard. Pretty cool, huh? Isn't it? That's the mustard of the mustard.
Very cool.
Joe, tell us about the wine.
Smelling it, even though we're in spring, thinking of mustard, I'm transported to fall with apples and pears. Kind of that
very true.
A crisp element. It's enjoyable on a spring day, but my palate reminds me of stone fruit or of palm fruits, and that crispness that comes with a green apple. And it's lovely. It's very refreshing.
A wine of all seasons. Well, I think the sheep want to see us, so I believe we need to get closer. We're going to caress the sheep. We're going to tell them that they're eating well. We're going to commend them for not being on a diet and going crazy, because that's what we need. We want it to be fully organic, and there's no more organic for Buena Vista than showing you how we do it. Animals are in charge. Sheep encircling. They're encircled, so they're gonna be able to feel our energy. We'll feel theirs.
Feel theirs, yes. We'll have to watch them and see, and they communicate with body language, as we do too. And knowing whether they'll want to run or will they let us approach them.
Exactly. So, Joe, tell us a little bit about the sheep and who they are and why they're so great as a beneficial animal to the farm.
Sheep are ruminants, and they are able to do a magical transformation of the grass into, well, as a gardener, I'm always worried about fertility and interested in fertility. They're able to take that with their four stomachs and be able to create a wonderful manure that's already decomposed and ready. Well, it's ready to be composted, but digested and transformed into energy. They're able to take the energy of the grass and give it to me for the garden, which is one of the few places where we can create energy. The sun does it through photosynthesis and through solar panels. Sheep, cows, ruminant animals can do that in the ability of taking the grass from the ground and transforming it into energy from their manure, which is very important.
So, dear friends, I recommend you have sheep at home. The way you want to have them, you see them in Central Park, you see them on Hyde Park, you see them now in Parisian neighborhood in a park, you see them cohabiting with, obviously, chickens and goats, and it's an exciting world, and we're here to create the perfect ecosystem. Look at where we are in the middle of California, in the North Coast of California, in the best place on earth. And we're going to enjoy now, Joe, a North Coast Pinot. And this is, again, Vinicultural Society. I'm going to take a little bit, and I'm going to give you the bottle because you deserve it. It may not be enough for your daily diet, but cheers, Joe.
Yes, cheers.
To the sheep, to the four-legged animals, and really to building this ecosystem, Joe.
Thank you. Yeah, the important part here, what we're doing with the sheep grazing in the vineyard, is being able to have them enclosed in an electric fence so that they'll eat everything evenly. If I let them just out in the vineyard in general, they would choose their favorite grass and only eat that one, and eat that one down to the nub, and not let that grass come back, and only weeds would then begin to spread. But by having them in here 2 days in two rows, and then we'll move them another 2 days so the next row's over. They'll be able to eat everything evenly, like a lawnmower or a tractor, and allow for this to be stimulated and come back evenly, and promoting healthy growth of our understory of our cover crop, as well as, for me, which is important, providing free food for our sheep. This is the season of summer, or no, this is the season, excuse me, of spring, where everything is green in California. We're able to harvest the rainwater into grass and then into
and sheep. I understand they've told me, specifically the darker sheep, they talk to me on a regular basis. They've told me they love mustard specifically. Why is that?
Well, the flowers are sweet. And then right now, as we saw that transition to the seed provides a little bit more protein. And this is an interesting time both in their development where we need a complex diet, carbohydrates from the grasses, the little bit of seed head and seed development, you're getting protein for their meal. So it provides for good development and growth for the sheep.
That's right. Mm-hmm. And Joe, when are we going to shear them actually? Because they have a beautiful, gorgeous wool. Look at this.
They have a wonderful fleece. We will shear them when we're out of the period of rain. We can't shear them if the wool is wet. It will rot the wool after it's off them. Mm. For them, it also the wool is their raincoat. It helps them stay warm. It also, it protects. It's amazing if you ever wore a wool sweater in the rain, you stay warm. It keeps you, it's waterproof.
That's right.
And that's what's working for them. So when we get into late April, beginning of May, we'll hire a shearer to come out, a professional who does a fantastic job. In a few seconds, he will have taken off all of the wool, their fleece, in one intact unit per one. And then we can process that fleece into yarn to have our own collection of.
And we will show you when we do that, because this is so much fun. We have the best shearman in California, who is actually the nationwide champion.
Correct.
That comes and help us do this, and this is so much fun. We've done mats in the guest house of Raymond and all kinds of different things with that beautiful fleece. So it's gorgeous. Joe, maybe you tell us what you think about this wine. Spectacular Pinot, really. I really commend Brian Maloney for this amazing wine. This is really not only charismatic, inviting, perfect for the season, not too heavy at all.
No.
So
it's a wonderful, wonderful spring wine. It definitely, to me, has a little bit of the roses. We're talking about different herbs that are out here, herbs in the grasses. And I get that kind of light little bit of spice that comes with that element. And then an earthy side of it as well. That's just has a nice backbone of kind of forest floor.
That's right. And this wine, as I look at the landscape, brings me excitement and peacefulness. You know, it excites all the envy that I have to be outside, as we are, and as well peacefulness in a way that it grounds me, maybe because it's a root day. Good root day in the biodynamic calendar, dear friends, and this is why maybe they're eating so much. They've done a whole row.
Yes.
They're going fast. They're probably one of our best employees, aren't they?
They're doing a great job.
High return, high return. All right, babies. So, dear friends, now we're coming closer to the sheep. They know Joe by first name. They know his touch. They know his feel. They're trying to escape because I'm kind of a new element. I only see them from far away. Babies, mes petits choux, mes bébés. Oh, let's try to feed them something. My babies, come, my babies. Come, my babies. See, that's a female. She's looking at me. She just winked at me. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! Didn't I do so well? Dear friends, I'm afraid to tell you, this is what used to happen to me in nightclub. I would come to the bars with a cluster of great good-looking ladies, and suddenly they would all escape, and I would find myself alone. Luckily, I have Joe today, and I know you'll do better than I do. So we're going to go back in a second. We're going to go close to the sheep, and Joe is going to show us one more thing that he does with the sheep that is not X-rated, but that is very important for the ecosystem. So stay tuned, a few more seconds.
as you can see, we've tried.
But the sheep always outwit us. They're much more clever than we are.
So never judge a sheep by its reputation. A sheep is often much smarter. So Joy and I will be eating our meal. Luckily, we have a great wine. Dear friends, thank you for being with us. Cannot wait to spring. Cheers.